free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
See, to live is to suffer. And to survive, well, that's to find meaning in the suffering.
Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I got to get up. On my feet so I can tear. Hey yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I got to get up. Get back on my feet so I can tear.
I've been through mad different phases, like mazes, to find my way. And now I know that happy days are not far away. If I'm strong enough, I'll live long enough to see my kids doing something more constructive with the time than bids. I know because I've been there. Now I'm in there. Sit back and look at what it took for me to get there. First came the ball, the drama with my mama. She got on some flash, so I split and said that I'ma be that seed that doesn't need much to succeed. Strapped with mad greed, a heart that doesn't bleed. I'm ready for the world, or at least I thought I was. Bagging when I caught a buzz, I was thinking about how short I was. Going too fast, it wouldn't last, but yo, I couldn't tell. Group homes and institutions prepare my ass for jail. They put me in a situation forcing me to be a man when I was just learning to stand without a helping hand. Damn, was it my fault? Something I did to make a father leave his first kid at 7 doing my first bid. Back on the scene at 14 with a scheme to get more green than I'd ever seen in a dream. And by all means, I will be living high off the hog. And I never gave a fuck about much but my dog. That's the only I'd head off in my last. Just another little come on, headed nowhere fast.
Hey, yo, I have a dream. One day, this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created.
That ain't the half. Gets worse as I get older. Actions become bolder. Heart got cold. Chip on my shoulder that I didn't touch. Didn't need a click cause I scared it that much. One deep with the starting for kicks. Catching Vicks, throwing bricks, getting by, being slick. Used to get high just to get by. Used to have to ball in the morning before I could fly. Ate something, couple of 40s made me hate something. After some hurt, now I'm ready to take some. 3 years later showing signs of stress. Didn't keep my hair cut or give a how I dress. I'm possessed by the darker side, living the cruddy life. Like this, kept with a bloody knife. Wanna make records, but I'm hooed up. I'm slipping, I'm falling, can't get up.
I have a dream.
I can't get up, I'm slipping, I'm falling.
My poor little children. One day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
Wasn't long before I hit rock bottom. Like damn, look how that got open like a window, no more endo. Look at a video, say to myself that could have been yo. On the TV, believe me, it could be done. Something got to give, got to change, cause now I got a son. I got to do the right thing for shorty, and that means no more getting high, drinking 40, so I get back, looking tight, slick again. Fake, jump back on my again. Nothing but love for those that know how it feel, and much respect to all my kept it real. You strong, kept it from doing wrong. Who they is, and this is your song. And to my boo, who stuck with it, I do. All the bulls, you'll get yours because it's due.
One day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted. Every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the south with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope.
I love you.
The man who
did you hear me?
Came by to get him to take him to death.
It's sad.
What?
And 30 years later, after
Have you seen this?
I got something.
But what you're fixing to witness now is the man who came by to get King to take him to dinner. And 30 years later at a press conference, he slipped because God do baffle your mind sometimes.
Some of the activities are geared especially for the young who did not have a chance to get to feel or to know what the civil rights movement actually was about. Even as they marched, now they could have stopped in a hotel, but when you think about marching from Memphis to Jackson or Jackson to Memphis, that went to hotels. You stayed in churches, you stayed in people's homes. And that's how we got over. That's how we got through. The struggle was a spiritual struggle. You couldn't pay people to do what we had to do. You couldn't pay people to stand before mad dogs and fire hoses and billy clubs and cattle prods. It was strictly a spiritual and moral movement. So we wanted that dimension to be in the pilgrimage to Memphis. We will revisit the mountaintop speech site. That's the Mason's Temple, where Dr. King made his last address, which he almost didn't make, because the night that we were having that rally, there were tornado warnings, and he was behind on the Poor People's Campaign. And he said, you guys go on over and have the rally. I'm going to stay at the motel and work on the Poor People's Campaign. When we got there and Dr. Abernathy walked in and Jesse Jackson walked in and I walked in and others, people started clapping because they thought Martin was behind us. And so Ralph's preacher sense said to him, this is not our crowd. And he went to the phone and called Dr. King. In those days, you have an opportunity to bring the children. Sharing with them the last hour of Dr. King's life. But that gave me the wonderful privilege of spending the last hour on earth. Three preachers in a room, Abernathy, King, and Kyle. And we spent that last hour together in room 306 at the Lorraine Motel. The press is always curious, and writers, what went on? What did you talk about? I say, we just talk preacher talk. What preachers talk about when they get together?
Y'all pay real attention to what you're fixing to hear now.
About a quarter of six, we walked on the balcony. And he was talking to people in the courtyard. He stood here and I stood there. Only as I moved away so we could have a clear shot, the shot rang out.
Okay, we want to do a run-through.
Did he just admit to...
So far, it's 2 mil black.
I mean...
I'm applauding some of the secrets that we keep.
31 robbers, go ahead. You got cars coming your way.
Speaking of lies, hide the truth.
2 male subjects, all dressed in black.
This man is a hypocrite. Abernathy, King, and Kyle. Do this to Dr. King. Why do we black on black crime? Why do we do that to each other?
Police! Police! Police!
Police!
Police!
Police! Police!
See your hand!
Police!
Your hand.
Police!
Hands! Hands!
Clear right! Did you clear?
All good!
Clear!
Hands up! Hands up!
On the ground! On the ground!
Let me find everything! Don't look at me! Cover!
Put your hands behind your back.
Put your hands behind your back! Put your hands behind your back! What's up with this guy?
Take his pulse. Make him grab.
Okay, I'm getting nothing.
Hands up!
I need an ammo, 103 South Major. 60-year-old male, possible heart attacks and an ambulance stack.
Shots fired, shots fired, shots fired.
Commander, we had a little bit of a situation
We had an older gentleman that went into cardiac arrest, which we did call an ambo for. We had a perp run out the back door, a young black teenager, about 17, 18 years old. Three shots were fired. Ambo was also called for him. We secured the perimeter. We're waiting on your next move and we'll have to figure out what to do. One negative, sir. We did the best we could.
Breaking news, protesters angry about police killings wanted to shut down traffic, and they were successful here in Chicago. This group stopped drivers on Lakeshore Drive in both directions between Oak Street Beach and North Avenue. Let's go right to CBS 2's Pamela Jones. She's with the marchers tonight. Pam.
I was there when the city announces Slager will be charged with murder.
I can tell you that as the result of that video and the bad decision made by our officer, he will be charged with murder.
Have you seen the news?
Yeah.
Are he gonna talk to your son?
What?
He needs you, Clarence.
Yeah. Wow. So, one of your friends died. You know, young people don't understand. You just can't be out here thugging, as y'all say. You gotta talk to you, boy. Talking to me.
Man, get off of me, man.
No, better keep your hands off. It's all support.
You know what? You ain't never taught me how to throw a ball, drive a car, or at least have $1 raise to break you out when you save. As a matter of fact, you never told me not to do drugs or drink. You never told me not to disrespect women, not to lie, cheat, hang on corners, the effect of cursing and vocal rap music and gangbanging. So for you to sit there and say you're gonna put your hands on me, ain't having it, man.
Well, I'm still your father.
Yeah, you right. You know what, buy me a belt. I can use the support.
What happened?
That's what he asked, just like you. By the way, that's all I ever watched for this week.
Congratulations! Oh, I'm so proud of you. Clarence! Hey, you know the outside of the house is really being neglected. Yes. Son, you can't blame yourself for what happened.
So you don't blame myself.
Everybody does.
I introduced him to drugs. I even gave Tick his first drink. And I laughed at him when he was sent to juvie. See, Tick wasn't about that life. All Tick talked about was school and God. And if that was the case, why God do that to him? To them? To me?
Look, Erica, I am not that person anymore. I'm
well,
maybe your son would influence mine.
There's a lot of things that I've done wrong, but you're not gonna tear down Benjamin. I am truly sorry about your loss. And I pray that one day that you can find peace in the situation. Okay.
It's time for me to stand on my own 2 feet.
Where did you come from?
I want someone going to be able to become a man. Man, you can't teach me.
Yeah, but you don't have to fail to be a man.
I just don't want to end up like that.
And you have to see. Look, we all have flaws, son. But your dad isn't all that bad.
What do you mean?
He's just more mad. I mean, when I found out I was pregnant with you, I didn't know who I was pregnant by. You know, it was between your father and a guy that I've been dating for 6 years.
Wait a minute. So you and Dad wasn't even together?
No. We were one. Benji, confessing this means nothing for me. It's for you.
I believe.
Benji, I believe a lot of what you're going through has a lot to do with my past.
Okay, this helps me out.
Well, the guy I love, your dad stayed.
And if he stayed, why did he marry?
I guess you couldn't tolerate the lying, the cheating, drugs, and the
prostitution. I don't believe. I don't believe.
You're right. It's time for you to be a man. It's time for Benji to know about Benjamin. Miss Jones. Tink's death isn't the only reason that Mrs. Jones doesn't like you. Benjamin, I made some mistakes. About 8 years ago, me and her husband had an affair.
What?
Yeah. He wanted to leave her and come with me, but I knew what I had to do was wrong.
Who are you?
Your mother. A woman who can admit that she's made mistakes. Hello.
Hello, how you doing? How can I help?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. Yourself?
Good. I'm Martha, Benji's mom.
Benji?
Mm-hmm.
Benjamin. Oh, Mr. Benjamin.
Yes.
Mr. Benjamin,
yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
How has he been?
Benjamin is good, actually.
Okay.
And that's the reason why I'm here.
Okay.
There's a couple reasons I came to talk to you. You Professor Flagg, right?
Yes, I am Professor Flagg.
Okay, Professor Flagg. So, Benji got an F from your class, and I'm trying to figure out why. I sent him to this nice, rich little school and spent all my money for him to come and be educated. But for some reason, Mr. Flagg, you giving him an F.
Well, he's getting F's because he hasn't been to my class. So that's the reason why he's failing. I haven't seen him in days. So if you're paying all of this money for him to come to this school, could you please make sure that he comes to this class?
Hold on.
Yeah.
Benji comes to school. I send him, I get him a bus pass every week, and he comes to class. I see him in the house.
doing his work for your class.
He's taking that bus pass. Well, he's taking that bus pass and he's going somewhere else because he's not coming to my class. And whatever paper that he's doing, he's not doing no paper from my class. That's what he's probably telling you, but it's not happening here.
I think this is really funny, Professor Flagg. Didn't speak very highly of you. But for some reason, you throwing my son under the bus.
I'm not throwing him under the bus. I mean, like, he's probably getting under that bus that you're sending him on to get.
But he's not coming here. This is going.
Yeah.
Okay, because see, I know he comes to class. Because, again, like I told you, I sent him to class. Now, if I have to speak to somebody else regarding you failing my class, what's your name? Dr. Flagg?
I'm sorry, it's Professor Flagg. But if you decide that you want to go talk to anybody, it's not going to make a difference. It's not going to make a difference if you talk to the supervisor, to the principal, to the dean, or whatever, because he's failing my class. So he needs to be here in my class. And if he was here in my class, he would not be failing.
My son is a smart young man.
That he is.
And he really doesn't even have to take your class or anybody else's class.
Well, if he want to graduate, he's going to have to take this class. Yes, he has to take this class. But your son has not been in this class, and I also have... Excuse me, attendance reports of your son not coming to class. None. Mr. Benjamin, no class, no show, no show, no show. Yes, I know who your son is.
Benji.
Third row, fifth seat.
Real handsome young man, real mild-mannered. Yeah, I don't know where he sits in here.
With an attitude like this.
With an attitude.
Yeah, just like yours.
First of all, if my son had an attitude, he wouldn't be enrolled in school. So you need to check that at the door, effing flag. That's what you calling my son, an effing flag like you. And I don't
My name is
flag.
Professor Flagg.
You know what, Professor Flagg? We're going to end this conversation. I think this conversation needs to be ended right now.
And if you are leaving, if you come back, please bring your son with you. Maybe he'll come to class with you.
Please do that.
Make sure that you do that.
You are failing kids' flag. That's who you are.
He needs to come
You are failing kids' flag. Our black boy. You fell it. Be happy.
Thank you for telling me you have a good day.
And the first question that I took the time to write down for you today to ask you was, are you happy with where you are in your life? I mean, are you satisfied with where you are in your life? Do you feel you can accomplish more? Because sometimes when we reach a point in our lives, we feel that we may be happy because we see the reaction of other people. Other people give their reaction to what you do or what you may say, and you will feel that, oh, okay, because this person is satisfied, then I am happy. No, what about you? Are you satisfied? Are you happy with your life at this particular point in time, if you were not skating? I mean, like, here's an example. Take the chair test. You know, just put a chair behind you, have someone be behind you, and just sit down. See what happens. You know, that's just go give it a try. You know, I mean, like, do you trust that person? I mean, do you trust that person enough that they won't snatch the chair from you? Because actually, you don't know what's going on behind you because you can't see. See, but that fear may stop you from actually trying to sit down. You see? And then that fear may have protected you because that chair may not be behind you. Then guess what? We all know you're on the floor. Not just some, not just half, not just a little bit. How would you feel if you achieved all of your goals? Most would say that you would feel fantastic. You would feel great. You will feel on top of the world. You will feel like you have conquered the world. You will feel that you can look down on anything. Yeah, literally look down on anything that was bad in your life because you will feel uplifted. You will have more confidence. You would have better self-esteem if you accomplished and achieved every goal that you decided that you wanted to achieve. Think about that question. That question there, that achieving and accomplishing your goals, how would you feel if you achieved all of them? You want to be a doctor, you want to be a lawyer, you want to be a judge, you want to be a police officer, you want to be a professor. Yes, that counts too. So, how would you feel if you achieved all of those goals? You know, ask yourself that question too. That question is also very important. Make sure that you understand these questions as well. Take time with these questions. Make sure you write this information down too, because we will also be studying more about these questions. These questions are very particular questions that help you get further where you need to go. It also helps you make better decisions as well, because you would know how you feel about these things. But you definitely have to be honest with yourself, because if you're not honest with yourself, just say you're not going to get too far. And another question that I've taken to write down is, what did I learn today? Let me repeat that. What did I learn today? My grandmother used to tell me all the time that you learn something new every day. I'm pretty sure all of you heard that statement. You learn something new every day. This is true. You learn something new every day. And what you learn every day, apply it into your life, whether it's good or bad. This question is, what is your why? I'm gonna repeat that. What is your why? Everybody has a why. Everybody does. I do too. I ask myself sometimes when I'm in class, I say, oh man, why is it going down like this? Why is it happening like this? Why is this? Why is that? When I get up and when I'm sick at home and I get up and I know I have to come teach this class, I'm like, oh man, why I gotta get up and class today? I don't feel good. Well, I'm pretty sure all of you had a why too. Oh man, why I gotta get up today and come to, you see, it's a why all the time. How big is your why? But here's the thing about that. If your why is big enough, you will always figure out the what and how. I know it's kind of hard to understand right now, but once you figure that out, everything else becomes simple. Because, say for instance, if you're hungry, you'll say, why do I need to eat? But duh, because you're hungry. So what do? You go figure out what you want to eat, and you try to figure out how you're going to cook it. And at that time, you figured everything out, and guess what? Full stomach. So it's just like knowledge. You know, it's just like learning. You know, why do I need to learn this? Why do I need to know about the events that happened in Ferguson? Why do I need to know about the events that happened in Florida with Trayvon Martin? Why do I need to know about the events that happened with Freddie Gray in Baltimore? The reason why you need to know these things is so that you can understand what you need to do so that these things will not happen in your community.
What you mean, what's up, Mom? What you doing here?
Your family know me too.
Yes, this is my family. This is my family. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We all family.
We all family.
What's up, baby? I mean, can a brother get a plate or something? Real tip? Something.
Hey, baby, how you doing? All right, nice day out here.
good to see everybody.
She don't want to see him, hey, it is what it is, but, you know, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make a drink. You know what I'm saying? As long as you take care of your business as a father, that's all that matters.
That's a horse don't want to drink.
Oh, no, nah, she ain't thirsty.
This ain't no time to fall apart. This is time to be together.
Okay? No. I'm talking. You hit it. Listen to me. We've been knowing each other too long. Finally listen to me, all right? Okay? This ain't no time to fall apart. It's time to come together.
You know what I've been going through.
I know, but God don't toss you curveballs. But see, He does that because you have to experience the down to appreciate the up. That's why He does that. Y'all got a son locked up. Y'all need to come together and talk about this and stop fighting. That's childish.
You don't even know. You have no.
What is it to know?
It's a lot to know what I've been doing these last 3 months. It's a whole lot to know.
Okay, so through those last 3 months, did you go see him?
Have you asked him what I've been doing for the last 3 months?
Have you went to see him?
Have I went to see him? No, I've been busy. I've been very busy.
Too busy to go see your son? Yep. Are you serious?
Exactly.
You must be kidding
yes,
me.
Yes, I've been
you
very
gotta
busy.
You got to be kidding me. Go very see your busy. Son.
You know what? I think I need to show you something. Because obviously, you won't get it.
Show me what?
Just follow me.
I want you to meet somebody. I want you to meet your granddaughter. I know you know. Yes. Yeah, that's your stinky granddad. Hey there, Mr. Black. So glad you can make it. It really means a lot to me.
I'm not supposed to be here. I'm not supposed to be here.
Yeah.
My son?
Yeah, you really have been his father. And I'm really blessed to have you in his life. And I'm just thankful we can do this together.
Yeah, we have to let the past be the past. I mean it.
Yeah.
It's all about him now. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you know what? I'm so thankful that today's his last day.
Yeah, yeah.
Today's his last day. And we're gonna let the past be the past.
Past be the past. It's all about
new beginning.
It's all about Benji.
It's all about Benji.
Let's go see.
All right.
It's good. Do you know where the registration office is? Can anybody tell me where the registration office is?
You yell a question, yet the answer you get is silence. It's almost like you're talking to yourself. The silence is only comfortable with those who choose to use it in matter of looks of it. I'm guessing you don't use it much, do you?
Look, man, I'm just trying to look for the registration office. That's it.
Down the hall, around the corner to your left.
Thanks.
Today, my friends, we still face difficult days ahead. We still have work to do, mountains to climb, and obstacles to overcome. We cannot stop striving yet. They won't get easier, life's challenges. But they will become more intricate, tricky. But when life's complexities confuse us, when the paradoxical ironies of existence surprise us, and when we are troubled by the uncontrollable external entities, both spiritual and physical, we must remember our ABCs. No, not the alphabet English majors of reading and writing, but the ABCs of life. And once we've learned them, we should take them with us as we let our lives do the singing. We should take the A and accept the challenge, the B and believe in ourselves, the C, convert our thoughts into hopes, and the D, the determination to convert our hopes into dreams. We should E, expect some obstacles on the way up, and F, fight while being faithful and finish the course. We should G, get God on our side, and H, have a Harvey model of leadership. We should I, inspire someone else, and J, take Jesus on our journey. We should K, keep on keeping on, and L, be a leader. We should M, make every day count, and N, never give up. We must O, overcome our obstacles, and P, put our best foot forward. We must Q, quit quitting, and R, run the race with patience. We must S, strive on, while T, trusting in the Lord. We should U, use our talents, and V, value our time. We should W, wait for understanding, and X, x-ray our own lifestyles. We should Y, yearn to achieve all that we seek, and Z, be zealous when reaching the top. Yes, we can reach the top.